Dabigatran is the active form of the orally bioavailable prodrug dabigatran etexilate. In this video, let's find found. What is dabigatran? What is dabigatran used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking dabigatran? How does dabigatran work? How to use dabigatran? What is dabigatran? Dabigatran, sold under the brand name Pradaxa, among others, is an anticoagulant used to treat and prevent blood clots and to prevent stroke in people with atrial fibrillation. Specifically, it is used to prevent blood clots following hip or knee replacement and in those with a history of prior clots. Dabigatran was approved for medical use in the United States in 2010. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. In 2020, it was the 306th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 1 million prescriptions. Dabigatran is a generic medication. What is dabigatran used for? Dabigatran is used to decrease the risk of stroke and blood clots in patients with a serious heart rhythm problem called nonvalvular atrial fibrillation. Contraindication. Dabigatran is contraindicated in patients who have active pathological bleeding, since dabigatran can increase bleeding risk and can also cause serious and potentially life-threatening bleeds. Dabigatran is also contraindicated in patients who have a history of serious hypersensitivity reaction to dabigatran, e.g. anaphylaxis or anaphylactic shock. The use of dabigatran should also be avoided in patients with mechanical prosthetic heart valves due to the increased risk of thromboembolic events, e.g. valve thrombosis, stroke, and myocardial infarction, and major bleeding associated with dabigatran in this population. Side effects. The most commonly reported side effect of dabigatran is gastrointestinal upset. When compared with people anticoagulated with warfarin, patients taking dabigatran had fewer life-threatening bleeds, fewer minor and major bleeds, including intracranial bleeds, but the rate of gastrointestinal bleeding was significantly higher. Dabigatran capsules contain tartaric acid, which lowers the gastric pH and is required for adequate absorption. The lower pH has previously been associated with dyspepsia. Some hypothesize that this plays a role in the increased risk of gastrointestinal bleeding. If a small amount of GI bleeding is diagnosed, the clinicians may consider adding H2 receptor inhibitor, H2RA, proton pump inhibitors, PPIs, and mucosal protective agent. In severe bleeding, measures include discontinuation of dabigatran immediately and administration of prothrombin complexitrate, packed red blood cells, fresh frozen plasma, the use of specific reversal agents such as idarucizumab for dabigatran, and emergency endoscopic management. Pharmacodynamic. Dabigatran is a reversible, potent, competitive direct thrombin inhibitor. Unlike heparin, which can only bind free thrombin, dabigatran is capable of binding and inhibiting both free and clot-bound thrombin. Understanding the role of thrombin in coagulation is central to a discussion of the mechanism of action of dabigatran and other anticoagulants. In contrast, direct thrombin inhibitors, such as dabigatran, can inhibit free, fibrin-bound, and clot-bound thrombin. Bivalent direct thrombin inhibitors, such as heparin and bivalirudin, bind both the active site and exosite. Univalent direct thrombin inhibitors, like dabigatran, bind only the active site. Additionally, the direct thrombin inhibitors reduce the platelet-aggregating effects of thrombin. Mechanism of action. Dabigatran, Pradaxa, reversibly binds to the active site on the thrombin molecule, preventing thrombin-mediated activation of coagulation factors. It may have less of an antagonistic effect on thrombin-mediated platelet aggregation. Half-life. The half-life of dabigatran is 12 to 17 hours, and 80% of the drug is renally excreted. Because prodrug and drug metabolism is independent of CYP enzymes, the drug is considered relatively safe in patients with moderate liver disease, but must be used with caution in patients with significant renal dysfunction. Dose. Stroke prophylaxis with atrial fibrillation. Prevention of stroke and systemic embolism associated with nonvalvular atrial fibrillation. CRCL greater than 30 milliliters per minute, 150 milligrams PO bid. CRCL 15 to 30 ml Ashmin, 75 milligrams PO bid. CRCL less than 15 milliliters per minute or dialysis, no data available, not recommended. AHA/ACC/HRS guidelines for atrial fibrillation. Class 1, for patients with AF or atrial flutter 48-hour duration and with high risk of stroke, for heparin or LMWH, or administration of a factor XA or direct thrombin inhibitor, is recommended as soon as possible before or immediately after cardioversion, followed by long-term anticoagulation therapy. Class IIA, for patients with AF atrial flutter of greater than or equal to 48 hours, or when the duration of AF is unknown, anticoagulation with warfarin, 2 to 3 Indian rupees, a factor XA inhibitor, or direct thrombin inhibitor is recommended for at least 3 weeks prior to and 4 weeks after cardioversion. Class II, for patients with AF or atrial flutter 48-hour duration who are at low thromboembolic risk, anticoagulation, for heparin, LMWH, or a new oral anticoagulant, or no antithrombotic therapy may be considered for cardioversion, without the need for post-cardioversion oral anticoagulation. For patients with nonvalvular AF unable to maintain a therapeutic INR level with warfarin, use of a direct thrombin or factor XA inhibitor. Not recommended in patients with AF and end-stage CKD or on hemodialysis because of the lack of evidence from clinical trials regarding the balance of risks and benefits, when or apixaban recommended. DVT or PE treatment, indicated for treatment of deep vein thrombosis, DVT, and pulmonary embolus, PE, in patients who have been treated with a parenteral anticoagulant for 5 to 10 days. Also indicated to reduce the risk of recurrence of DVT and PE patients who have been previously treated. CRCL greater than 30 milliliters per minute, 150 milligrams PO bid. CRCL less than or equal to 30 milliliters per minute or on dialysis, dosage recommendations cannot be provided. CRCL less than 50 milliliters per minute with concomitant use of PGP inhibitors, avoid co-administration. DVT or PE prophylaxis. Indicated for the prophylaxis of DVT and PE following hip replacement surgery. CRCL greater than 30 milliliters per minute, 110 milligrams PO 1 to 4 hours after surgery and after hemostasis has been achieved on first day, then 220 milligrams taking Q-day for 28 to 35 days. If dabigatran is not started on the day of surgery, after hemostasis has been achieved, initiate treatment with 220 mg Q-day. CRCL less than or equal to 30 milliliters per minute or on dialysis, dosing recommendations cannot be provided. CRCL less than 50 milliliters per minute with concomitant use of PGP inhibitors, avoid co-administration. Safety advice. Dabigatran has not been studied in children or in pregnant or breastfeeding women. It is a U.S. Food and Drug Administration pregnancy category C drug. That's all the information about dabigatran we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.